afternoon, sir.
Okay. So today we are going to discuss about. So today we are going to discuss about, you know, how to communicate effectively. You know, everybody, day and night we do, you know, speak or we communicate something to each other. Okay. Be it verbal, be it non-verbal. So in the same regard, we are going to talk about, you know, communication, how to communicate effectively. It's not about, you know, that we are speaking or we are good on speaking. It's all about how effectively we do communicate. Everybody kindly keep yourself on mute mode. Actually, your you know, noise is coming from back end, so I'm not able to hear you properly. Everybody kindly mute yourself, please. Yes. So we were here that every day we do communicate. Okay. We do communicate every day. Every day, you know, in a day, in 24 hours, we do communicate in anyhow at least for 17 to 18 hours. 17 to 18 hours used to be a good time. Okay. That communication could be, that communication could be or would be with your colleagues, with your boss. You could be in a seminar, you could be in a meeting, you could be in a, you know, public area, you could be in a, you know, meeting, or you could be in any marriage function on any. Okay, so here the most important is how effectively we do communicate, that it leaves an impression on the other person to whom we are communicating. Okay, and also, the communication, what we are going to communicate, what you are going to deliver, should be intact. It should be, you know, completely make understood to the person to whom we are going to communicate.
How to communicate.
So, yeah. So there are some points what we are going to discuss now. And communicate is a like a weapon. Okay. With communication, we can, you know, win any war. Like, we can, you know, become very good to others. We can make our we can leave our impression. Okay. And by this, we can make limitless earnings also. The persons who are good on technical skills or who are having very good technical skills, but are not good on, you know, communication skills, then they will not be able to express whatever they do have inside them. Okay. Now, the next comes, what type of communications are there? How do we communicate? Communication used to be in two words, like, you know, verbal and non-verbal. The verbal can be while we speak to anybody. It could be, you know, with our colleague, with our boss, like I told you earlier, in seminar, in marriage party, etc. Okay. Then when we talk about non-verbal communication, it's all about like writing email, doing WhatsApp chat, letter writing, putting any leave application to anybody. Okay. Now, there are some tips. Everybody kindly keep yourself on mute mode, please. I'm getting, you know, so much noise from behind. Thanks to everybody who are having on themselves on mute mode, and the persons who are not right now on mute mode, kindly keep yourself on mute mode so that everybody can listen. Okay, so now let's proceed ahead. Now, there are some tips to communicate. First, the tip is to communicate is to try to speak. Whenever you are in any meeting at, or you are at any place, you should at least try to speak. You should at least try to speak. Read words carefully. Sometimes we do read somewhere like we are reading something in this way. We are not getting properly. We are not, you know, making people, other people understood, but we are reading. Okay. Sometimes we read silently, but to make our communication effective, it's most important that we read words very carefully. Okay. Then is watch videos on YouTube. You can watch some videos on YouTube to make, you can talk to yourself loud while you are alone. Okay. And for getting all these good communication skills or to be very good on the communication part, it's most important that you work on VAR level. Okay. It should not be like we put efforts one day and we are not, another time we are not putting. Sometimes we think, yeah, what's the matter? We are sitting with our friends. We can communicate in any way. No, the moment you are going to communicate with someone, you should, you know, speak in such a way. And you, it's not about only speaking, it's about, you know, speaking and listening, because communication is a two-way process. How much effectively you will listen, that much effectively you can speak. If you will not listen to anybody, nothing it is going to be, you know, work that you will have a good communication. Because if you will not listen to the, you know, reactions or the questions or the queries, what the, you know, the person to whom you are facing, then you cannot give a proper answer to him. Okay, so first of all, take time to think before you speak. Okay, never speak like this, that you are keep on going speaking anything anywhere. First of all, think, take time to think that this is the thing what I am going to speak, and choose proper words. It should not be like this, we are speaking proper words that make or leave impression on other person that yeah, he's in a such a good way. Okay, like there used to be, you know, many people do give a, you know, negative answer or do deny so many things. Some people do deny, but it looks like he's not denying, but he's saying no, yeah, he has given. But some people do deny in such a way that, you know, it makes bad impact on other person and people do feel annoyed. Okay, so it should not be like that way. We should respond to someone in such a way that he do feel it positive. Then is next is be slow to speak and quick to listen. We should always, you know, speak very slowly, not in such a way slowly also that a person who is sitting in front of you or to whom you are, you know, discussing or to whom you are talking, he gets bored that you speak a word and then you are not speaking for next 1 minute. Okay, it should not be like that way also. But what you should do is you should be slow to speak and quick to listen. You should listen to the things quickly. That what he is saying, if you will be able to listen, then you are going to make it an effective communication between the two persons. Okay, or it could be in while we are talking to our friend, while we are talking to our boss, while we are writing mail to our, you know, boss or our colleague, then also we should pay very much attention while writing an email. Words should be chosen in a proper way. Words should not hurt anybody, and words should be always in a positive, you know, manner, and it should always leave a positive impact on the person to whom we are going to discuss. Then we speak to help the listeners. When you are speaking to somebody, okay, speak in such a way that you are going to help the listener. Listener, now what is the meaning of helping the listener? The meaning of helping the listener is, yes, ma'am. Achha, give me a second. Done. I have done them all in, ma'am. Okay. So what is the point here is, speak to help others. It should not be your motto that you are keeping on going speaking. You are speaking limitlessly. Either someone is listening or not. Someone is getting or not. But what should be your motto is, you should help your audience get the message. Everybody kindly keep yourself on mute mode, please. So much noise is coming from background. Everybody kindly keep yourself on mute mode, please.
Hey, Bonang, Pooja, Praveen, Stuti, keep on mute, no?
Okay, so let's proceed ahead. Okay, now the point here is to speak to help listeners. Means with the moment we are speaking, the moment we are communicating with someone, it's most important that the person to whom we are going to communicate or the person to whom we are going to deliver any message, he must understand that. Now the same case happens in case of, you know, non-verbal communication. Say for example, we are writing any email to anybody. Okay, so the mail should be in such a, mail should be written in with such words that the person with whom you are going to communicate or to whom you are going to send that message, send that letter, send that email, he must understand the meaning of those words. Okay, sometimes what is the trend nowadays, people do write such heavy words or new words by either by taking from dictionary or, you know, by reading newspaper and some other, you know, magazines. The people have learned so many new words that generally people do not know. okay, and they do put such words in their writing while writing email or while writing, you know, WhatsApp communication with other. So that's the person have to take, you know, this you know, the help of the dictionary, then only he can understand those words. So it should not be in that way. It should be in such a way that a person to whom we are going to discuss, he should understand the things very easily. Now the next point is, next part comes is, speak with straightforwardness. Now many people, what do they do? Keep on doing beat about the bus. They do keep on taking the things here, there, here, there, but they do not talk straightforward that this is the scenario, this is the thing, this is the message what I'm going to deliver. But to take time, what they do is, they do keep on, you know, keep beating about the bus. That should not be there. So what should be there? The message should be very clear. Message should be very straight that this is the thing what I'm going to discuss with you. This is the matter. This is the point. What I want to discuss with you. What I want to, you know, tell you. It should be in such a way. And the next thing we should, you know, care about is be aware that nonverbal communication is always at work. Sometimes people do not, you know, care about the nonverbal communication. Now, what do we mean by? Although I have already told you about the nonverbal communication, but what do we mean by nonverbal communication at work is? It means the body language, the posture, okay, the facial expressions, the eye leading, okay, when a person is making his eye here and there, dress, clothing, you know, and then is most is behavior, how a person is behaving, how he walk, how he talk, how he is, you know, behaving, how he is standing, how much attention he is paying to any communication. Okay, so this is the thing. These are the things what a person should take care of. Then is recognize three things while we are doing a spoken communication. Okay, verbal. Obviously, the words. Okay, the words should be chosen in a proper way. Like the most people concentrate on the verbal elements. Okay, assuming this to be the masses, when is it only the part of the masses? Next is vocal. Vocal means intonation, projection, resonance. The moment we are communicating with someone in verbal comes, then comes vocal. Vocal means intonations, your projections and resonance. Okay? And the next part is visuals. Say for example, you are, you know, a team leader and you are taking meeting of your team members. Now if you are expressing something in visuals, you are expressing something in face, in the, you know, in pictures, in charts, in, you know, tables, then the message goes much clearer rather than the speaking, because pictures or the pictures do, or the motions, expressions, or the body language, your facial expressions, these all play very vital role while you communicate. Okay, and be careful to use right words at the right time. Now, what do we mean by here? Using the right words at the right time. Using right words at right time is when we are talking to someone, we should always choose the right words. It should not be in such a way that a person to whom we are communicating, he do feel bad, he do feel embarrassing, or he do feel that he is being insulted. So words should be proper. Say what you mean and what you say. What is the meaning? That should be the same. Okay. Good habit to get into it is thinking through what you intend to say. Be sure that indeed what you mean to say, whatever your intention is to say, that only should be said over there. It should not be like, you know, you're trying to say something and you're saying something. Okay, then sometimes be tactful. Okay, be tactful and be firm. It happens many times. We are, say for example, we are in a meeting. Okay, and the meeting could be, you know, with your boss, it could be with your colleague, it could be with your friends, it could be with anybody. Okay, now the most important part there used to be, sometimes what we do is we are saying something, okay, we said something, but the moment we start to say something, we do start with a good voice, I'm talking about volume, good voice volume, and till the time we end, our sentence or word, what we do is our voice comes very low. Okay, our voice becomes very, you know, slow. It should not be there. Okay, so whatever message we are going to deliver, it should not be very loud also. That the person with whom you are talking, with whom you are communicating, you feel in such a way that he's making his impression. It should not be like that also. It should be very gentle. It should be very firm. It should be very tactful, that this is the point what I am trying to communicate. Okay. Then is make good use of questions. Now, what do we, while communicating, what is the meaning of making good use of questions? Questions, queries. Actually, like I told you earlier also, communication is a two-way process. In communication, it should always be remembered, or it should always be in mind that we have to make the communication two-way. Okay, or the interactive. Communication should be always interactive. Like I'm keep on going delivering each and something, either you are getting or not, that doesn't care. I have a message that I am delivering, that's it. It should not be like that. It should be the persons who are sitting, or the audience who are facing, or the person with whom we are communicating, he should be interactive. If he will be interactive, definitely he is going to ask some questions. If someone is asking some questions, he is having some queries in mid of your communication, it means he has interest, he is taking the things, he is understanding what I am saying, and he do have interest. Sometimes what happens, we are going to any seminar and we are sitting in it, you know, on the benches behind or on the chairs. Whatever the person who is delivering, we are not understanding him. Whatever he is saying, let him say. We don't mind. Okay. But some person used to be there who sits on the front seats and listen each and everything very carefully, ask relevant questions. The questions also should be relevant. It should not be like the people are saying something and you are saying something. Person ask any other question, you are answering something else. So the same part like everybody, please keep yourself on silent mode. I'm not able to get you. And so much voice is coming from behind. Rati Ayer, Dev Visri, are kindly keep yourself on mute mode. Everybody hold for a second. Actually, I'm muting all those people who are not on mute mode. Yeah. Rati, do not switch on your audio, please. Rati Ainer, please do not switch on your audio, please. I'm switching you to mute mode and you are again unmuting. Yeah. So make good use of questions. The questions should be relevant, and you should keep on raising questions so that you can check whether people are getting you or not. Okay. Next is look for the teachable moments or clarification or self-discovery. Okay. In this, what you have to do is do this by stopping other person at the critical points and asking what he or she is thinking. Now, say for example, you are saying something, okay, or you are telling something about any project, about any story, about any news, you are telling something to anybody. Okay. Now, what you can do is you can raise questions, or you can ask for some clarifications. Hi, Mr. Do you know it? You can ask them like this. Do you have any idea about it? So in this way, what you can do is either the person who is facing you or the with whom you are communicating, either he will, you know, have your full attention to your side. He will have his full attention towards you, and he will think, yeah, he is asking me something. Then you can, if he knows, then he will tell you something about that. He will tell some points that this is this. If he do not tells that this is this, then what he or she will do is he will ask you, sir, please let me know what it is. If you are on senior authority, he will say, sir, yes, by name, whatever it could be. It depends upon the situation, with whom, how, at what point you are discussing with someone. Okay. Next comes, find out in advance An arranged conference talk is about. Now, it's like, you know, if we are going to talk with somebody, then we must be, if we are going to communicate with somebody, we must be priorly aware, or we should be, you know, known to the fact that what we are going to discuss, what we are going to say to anybody. Okay? Say, for example, if you are asked to meet with someone and you suspect it is not merely for a fun or a social occasion, then ask if the other person to do you courtesy of telling you in advance the purpose of the meeting. Now, it is like, you know, you are going somewhere and you start from your home and you don't know where you want to go. The communication should not be like that. Communication always should be that you must be aware that this is the fact, this is the point about what I am going to discuss, about what I am going to have a communication with anybody. Okay. Next comes record important matters. Now, in any meeting, in any conference, in any seminar, in any kind of meeting, in any formal or informal meeting, when you are going to discuss something, then record important matters. Okay. You should record each and everything that what is going to be done. In some contexts, this is crucial, such as when personally meeting an opponent. Righty, Ainar, please go and keep yourself on mute mode, and if you have some kind of query, kindly let me know. Everybody kindly keep yourself in mute mode. Some of the people are there who are not still on mute mode, and I'm not able to, you know, communicate properly.
Hold on, Rati, Yoshna Raj, please mute yourself.
Okay, so we were discussing about record of important matters. In some contexts, this is very crucial, such as when personally meeting an opponent or an antagonist, or during a very important committee or team meeting. As a sticker for this practice, one of his maxims was, I am a strong believer in transition official businesses by the written words. Sure, whatever we are going to discuss, that at least the key points should be recorded, that these are the points what I am going to discuss, about what I am going to make the people aware. So that point should be precisely maintained, precisely written, that this is the all what I am going to talk about. Then next is, do not permit interruptions. Now what happens many times when we are discussing something, when we are delivering any, you know, seminar, any webinar or any other thing, okay, what some people used to, there used to be many kind of people in this you know, scenario in this world. Some people used to be there who are there just to disturb the things, who are there to interrupt. So avoid such people by giving them clear instructions that please do not interrupt in bit. Okay, or ask them, make them stand up, or ask them straightforward that what your queries are, kindly let me know once. Or you can instruct them that you can ask me your queries after this meeting, after this seminar or webinar in person, but do not interrupt in mid. Or if you have something to interrupt in, if it is important to interrupt in mid, then let me know in one go so that I can give answers to all of your queries in one go. Okay. Then use paragraphics. Okay. If a matter is important enough, then paraphrases back what was said, or have your listeners paraphrase back to you what you have said. Now it's like, you know, reminding people what you have said earlier. In some meetings, we do keep on discussing many things. Say, for example, we discussed in initial, at the first point, we discussed that communication is such an important thing. Some communication is some important tool that is required to be used by us at least 17 to 18 hours. So it is all about use paraphrasing. Paraphrasing means remind the previous ones what we discussed. Okay. If we will remind people the previous things, what we discussed in previous meeting, what we discussed in previous seminar, what happened in last meeting, what happened in, you know, that case. If we will remind people in such a way, then the discussion will be more interactive and interesting. Okay. Then is, give me a second, please. Then is summarize meetings. Okay. Whatever the meetings you have, you need to summarize them all. That this is about this, this is about this, this is about this. Next is to get help when communicating with other person is difficult. Sometimes what happens, we are, you know, not able to communicate with some people in a proper manner. Then in such a case, what you can do is you can take help of the same person. That what is the problem that you are not going to understand me? You are not getting me. Where the communication gap is there? Okay. Communication gap can be in many ways. It could be a language hurdle. Like, I know any other language, you know any other language. Okay. One. Second is the medium through which we are communicating. I'm using any another medium, you are using any another medium. In technical way, things could be different. Okay. Sometimes, say for example, we are delivering something through the mic, through the power of mic, and the mic is not going too good. That is going to some make some problem. Okay. Again, please keep yourself on mute mode. Everybody, please keep yourself on mute mode. Okay. Then is get rid of restrictions. Whatever restrictions you have, you need to get rid of them. Okay. Like on the positive side, there are benefits. Then when you put away anything that can intrude you upon your discourse with others, the benefit include but not limited to, by, you know, get rid of restrictions, what you can do is being able to converse in a more meaningful way, showing mutual respect. You can show mutual respect to peoples, which has a strong probability of elevating your relationships. Increase the chances of actually getting something accomplished. You are able to better focus on each and other upon the topic or agenda. You can remember the conversation and the most likely the silent points on later time. Okay. This is all about the, one second, please. So everybody, welcome back to the session. So it was all about how the communication is going to play a role in our lives. Okay. How effectively we can communicate with others. So there were some points like keeping all the things on, keeping the restrictions away, making key points, keeping yourself, you know, prepared for the meetings. So there were so many points what you can learn about or what you can keep in mind while communicating with anybody. Okay. Now, if you do have some of your queries related to placements, related to any other topic, or if you need any kind of further assistance from our side, I am there to help you out. All of you are requested to, there are so many number of, you know, participants. So you are requested to kindly keep your, you know, ask your questions turn by turn so that others also can have their queries resolved. Thank you.
Hello.
Yes, please.
Hi, this is Shweta. This is regarding a placement mail which I got, which I have received from your side, that is IIBM side.
Okay.
But later on, I haven't received any anything from IIBM side regarding placement and all. In that mail, it was asked to send you our resumes or CVs.
Mm-hmm.
So I have sent it. So I haven't received any mail from your side later.
Okay, Shweta, what was that mail containing any, you know, placement opportunity, or that was general mail to share your CV?
Yeah, just to share my CV, nothing else than that.
Okay. So, Shweta, I hope you would have got a link also from our side, link to register for the placements.
No.
Have you got any link from our side?
No, I'll have to search. If you have that mail, you can send it to my mail ID. But I haven't received such mail, I think. I'll have to search again.
So, Shweta, the best way will be you need to talk to your counselor. Okay. She will give you a link. If you will fill up that form, your details will be shared with me directly. Okay. And from there, I'll whenever I'll be sharing, you know, placement opportunities with all of you, then you will get those emails. Like, what is your course, Shweta?
Like last time, I had a discussion. I have done civil engineering.
Okay, that one. Okay, great.
Yes.
I recalled you properly. Yeah, I recalled you completely.
I have a prior experience also, and on that basis,
Shweta, I remember that very well. Okay. Okay, that's not a problem. Okay. But you were doing some kind of internship from us, okay, or from
our institute. I'm doing right now.
Okay.
Yes.
So, for that, what you need to do is you need to talk to your counselor. She or he will give you an ATJ card. Once you get that ATJ card, you will be eligible to apply for the placements from our side.
So, before link, do I have to take that ATJ card or filling that link?
Yeah.
After filling
that. You can pull the link, but for filling that form also through that link, you need ATJ card so that you can apply, because that ATJ card is mandatory.
Yes, sir.
Hello, sir.
Hi, sir.
Hello, this is Prasanjit.
Yeah, Prasanjit. How are you?
Yeah. Fine, sir. Sir, how can I get an ATJ card, sir?
That is ATJ card. It's very simple, everybody. Who do have question related to ATJ card? It's very simple to get it. You need to talk to your counselor through whom you have taken admission. Okay. Ask to her that, madam or sir, I need ATJ card so that I can be eligible to apply for the placements. That is the very simple point to get a ATJ card through your counselor. He or she will let you know the whole process of getting the ATJ card.
Okay, sir. Okay. Thank you, sir.
Yeah. Hello, sir.
Yeah, please. Mukund, tell me.
Sir, I want to know about grapevine communication.
You want to know about?
Grapevine communication. Grapevine communication.
Grapevine. Okay. So see, now actually, we are going to talk about some queries related to placements here. For this, what you can do is you can take my number and we can discuss it about later on. Because if we will go in deep of the communication skills or the, you know, the grapevine communication kind of things, it will take so much time of you peoples. And this meeting is very limited, time limited. Okay, in 45 minutes it will be over, and 42 or 43 minutes already have been. I'm writing my number here. Okay. So everybody who do have any kind of such queries,
5 o'clock then ready varuvaanga.
Anybody else, please?
Hello. Yeah. Yes, hello. Hi, sir. Vibhor this side.
Yeah, Vibhor. Yeah, Vibhor. Yeah, yeah.
Hello. Yeah, actually, sir, what is the right time to call you, sir? Actually, last time I called you, but you told that you are busy. So, can you tell me what is the right time to call you? I have some query related.
Hello. Before, just after finishing this meeting, you can call me. Okay, I'll talk to you in a proper manner. That is not a problem. I'll give you full time. Okay, or what you can do is drop a message to me.
If you don't mind, sir, if you don't mind, can I call you after 6:30? Is the right time to talk?
Not a problem, yeah. Not a problem. You can do. You can do before. I got your email also.
Okay, sir.
I got your email also. I dropped an email to you. I hope you remember regarding a placement opportunity.
And
you replied to that.
But I have some. Yeah, I have some query. So just okay, sir. I call you after 6:30. It is the right time to contact you, sir.
Not a matter of worry, yaar. You can talk to me anytime. You just what you need to do
sir,
is
your number is 8979 right? I have your number in my phone. So
that is my number. That is my number.
Okay. Thank you so much, sir. Thank you.
Sir, I will call you after the meeting.
Hello, sir.
Yes, please.
Hello.
Yes, please.
Yeah, this is Rimpa. So I actually wanted to take a reference of a CV because this will be my first opportunity. So I do not have any much knowledge about how, since my course is about data science.
Mm-hmm.
So I would like to know once, like, means how a CV is being CV should be placed so that I can get a better opportunity. Yes.
Very good question you have raised here. Actually, yeah. CV is the something what do leaves your first impression with any company HR, okay? Or the recruiter who is going to recruit you. For this, what I'll do is I'll take another session also, okay? That how to write a good resume. And what should be mentioned in a resume and what should not be mentioned. Sometimes you do think that this is your strength and you mention that in your CV. But from some company's perspective, that could be a weakness or your recruiter is not any more interest to have such kind of skills in a candidate and your CV gets rejected. Okay. So, for meantime, what you can do is I have shared my number here. You can just ping me on WhatsApp, sir, that I'm here. Okay. On this, I had a word with you. What I'll do is I'll send some sample CVs with you, general sample CVs from the perspective of a fresher. There are so many tips on the resume writing, like a fresher's resume should not be more than one word. Okay. And on resume, it should not be written curriculum vitae, but it should be written simply as resume. Okay, these are some tips. What I'll tell you in more in details once you WhatsApp to me, and I'll share some examples of CV or sample CVs.
Sure, sir. I will just ping you up.
Okay, Rimpa. Thank you so much.
Yeah. Thank you, sir. Hello.
Rimpa, kindly keep yourself on mute mode.
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Just a second.
Rati, you want to ask something? Rati Ainar, you want to ask something?
Hello?
Yes, please.
Hello? Hello, sir. This is Ranjit Kumar.
Okay.
Sir, my course is data science, sir.
Mm-hmm.
But I have some doubts in data science course. How will I clear that doubts, sir? How will I clear the doubts?
What kind of doubt you do have in that?
Sir, some concepts I have doubts for executing Python. Executing programs in Python.
Your good name is?
Yes. Sir, Ranjit Kumar, sir.
Ranjit Kumar. Ranjit, yes. I'm writing your query, okay? You're requested to kindly take my number and put me a message.
Yes.
Okay? So
yes.
This is the problem, sir, I do have. And our team from the content development will have a word with you.
Yes. Okay.
So and we are always looking for the inputs from, we are always looking for such inputs so that we can improve our course curriculum. Okay?
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Sir Anuj is speaking. Sir, please share the mail ID also.
Yeah, just a second, Anuj.
Please share the mail ID. your mail ID.
Yeah, I'm doing that right away.
Okay, sir. Thank you so much.
And everybody, best part will be you can get my details from your counselor. You can talk to your counselor. He or she will give all of my details. Okay, all of the details of the placement side, and that will be a great help for all of you as well as me. How much excited you are to get a job? Equally excited I'm also to get you give something, so that I also feel happy that yeah, there is something that I have done for you all.
Thank you so much.
Okay.
Hello,
hey,
sir. Hello, sir. My name is Netra. Videos in I'm doing data science. So some videos in the Python. They are so.
Beta, what would be great is for such kind of queries, you can talk to your
তোমাকে এররটা দেখাচ্ছে
না গুগল মেসেজে দেখতে
স্যার হাই স্যার
আমি ক্যান স্পিক ফর
ইউ ওই তোমাকে বললাম যে দিতে
রাহুল হ্যাভ এনি
প্রেজেন্সি ও টাকাটা অন্তত একটা এমন বলো
সরি রাহুল
হ্যালো
ইয়েস প্লিজ রাহুল টেল মি
Yeah, I'm really sorry to tell this because I think the ethics of the meeting are not happening in our session. The way it is happening, if it is something good, we can receive it very good. And if there is any presentation also, we can feel better and understand it very well. We are communicating very good manner, but the thing is the outcome that we want to learn. If there is any visualization or PPT, something there, will very well understanding about it.
Okay, so that while speaking, you can see also that what's it all about. Yeah. So that if there is any doubt and if any word has been skipped, you can learn that through that PPT. You are saying like that. Am I right?
Yes. Anything that can be visualized.
Okay.
And one more thing that I feel I'm really sorry to say this, and in between the session I can find that you are lifting the call and talking. And some other noise is also coming. So I think this is not a great way of conducting any meeting. I want to say this.
Vinod, actually any other voice was not there. There was just a phone call, a phone meeting, phone disturbance, okay?
Yeah, I understand it is important call, but you can stop the sharing and you can talk.
Yeah.
Because seeing is not feeling good, I can say.
What is not feeling good?
It's not about negative. Like, see, you can stop sharing of your screen and you can talk, because that will be, it will not affect us.
That's okay. Yeah. We will keep it in mind. Thank you. Thank you so much for your valuable suggestions.
And please try to maintain PPTs for the session so that
PPTs,
if you can share with us.
Actually, that is your good point, Vinod. Actually, what is that? I generally do not make PPTs because by PPT it becomes like what we have written and we are speaking it in this way. Okay. But what I believe is whatever as much as the session could be, interactive, it would be much better. By PPT we are having a PPT and we are keeping speaking something about that. That I do not feel good. I want that if I communicate something, you must get that. It should not be like that ki I have to take help of something written. It is good. We should take. I also tell that to make the communication much effective, you must have some kind of written or pictorial form or data in pictorial form. But yes. Anyways, if you feel it in that way good, then we can do that. Okay. So everybody, it is being time. Time is being over for this meeting, and Zoom is again giving me some instructions that this time is up. So I have to leave for the day. Thank you so much, everybody. Let's meet next Monday. Okay. Thank you so much, everybody.
Sir.
Yes, please.
Yeah, this is Shobhit from Kolkata.
Yeah, Shobhit.
Yeah, I have doubts regarding my course. I am in data science course.
Okay.
So I have doubts regarding placement.
Okay.
So can you clear about the placement? After I have experience in data science also.
Okay.
I am doing internship in with Edureka.
Sovik, see, you need not to worry about your placements. Okay. If you have got your ATG card, talk to your counselor.
No, I have not received it.
Give me a second. Let me complete, please. Talk to your counselor. Okay. She will give you a ATG card. With that, she will give you a link also. Okay. And by that link, you can apply for the placements. And definitely placement cell is going to help you a lot in getting a job. That would be in your region also. That would be in Delhi NCR, Ahmedabad, Bangalore, Pune, in these regions itself. Okay. And you are very proud. You should be very proud that you have taken admission in such a course. For that, there is very huge demand in market now.
Yeah.
Okay. So it Thanks is ATG card. Whosoever is asking that, what is card? It is ATG card.
Hello, very good evening, sir.
Yeah,
hello, sir. Hello. One more question I would like to ask you. So when the placements is going to start?
1 second. You are in which course? Which course you have done from us?
It's in data science.
Data science, okay.
Yeah.
That is all about once you get ATG card, we will start to give you placement services. Okay. And already we have started to give to some people. Some of you might have like before have got already a placement opportunity from our side. You can there are few candidates who have already got some placement opportunities from us.
Okay.
Okay, so okay. Time is up, guys. I'm so sorry.
Hello, very good evening.
What is the maximum package?
Package totally depends upon your skill sets. That what kind of skill sets you do have, and we do have different kind of companies, different kind of packages. And it do keep on coming.
Sir, this is, yeah, this is Saipan from Vijayawada, sir.
Okay.
I will suggest you one thing. Can you please provide a session for placements?
Yeah,
it definitely will be helpful to us.
Yeah, definitely. Positively, next time, we will discuss about, you know, how to get jobs through Naukri.com or how to search job on Naukri.com. Also, we will discuss about how to strategically handle or, you know, manage the interview session properly, or, you know, for the session of, you know, the online interviews.
Sir, I have a question.
Excuse me, sir.
Yeah, please.
I am Azul from Bihar.
Mm-hmm.
Sir, I also observed that in module apps, I cannot get any live lectures. What can I do?
Yeah, the live lectures are not happening.
Pooja, that yes, would sir. Be there, and Ujwal, that would be there. Okay, but for that, what you need to do is you can talk to your counselor, please. It will be great help if you can directly tell to them. I'll also take it as input. Okay. For live lectures.
Okay, sir.
I'll take it as input and we'll forward it to the, you know, academic team. Definitely they will go, they will assist you in this regard.
Thank you, sir.
Okay.
Sir, so hello.
Yes,
hello, sir. Myself Shudipta Roy. I would like to say something about the how to apply the ATG card through the link. Can you share the link on the email ID?
Sudipta, there is a miscommunication actually. I said once you get the ATG card, okay, then you will get a link. After getting ATG card, you will get a link from our side. Okay, that will be probably be given by your counselor, by whom you have taken admission. Okay, and then you will be eligible to apply for the jobs. Now, I'm so sorry, everybody. This Zoom is giving me instructions again and again that please, or reminders again and again that please. Session is about to be over. So thank you for the day.
Sorry, sir. If I have any queries regarding ATG card, then I need to contact the respective phone number in a chat session. No, I have seen that.
You can chat on that also, or it would be great if you can talk to, you know, your counselor.
Okay.
That will be great help.
Okay, sir. Okay, sir. Okay, actually, I have a yes, sir. I have a counselor number, but I think he has left that job from the IIBM Institute. That's
okay. Yeah. Then I'll help you. You can write on that number. Okay, I'll assist you. I'll give someone will call you from our team. Thank you.
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, everybody. Thank you, everybody. Bye.